In this episode, I show you how I use a theodolite to set up square lines on a slope. Welcome to episode 2 of the Split Level Deck Build Series. And also, we have a sneak peek of the next build series that I'm working on too. So be sure to click subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss out when I release that series. So, when I was doing the setup for this job, I was working alone, and with the added challenge of working on the slope, the easiest way for me to establish these square lines was to use a theodolite. During my 10 years at a commercial construction company, we often used a theodolite to set out square lines over long distances and to transfer plumb lines up multiple stories. And whenever we did a slope project, the theodolite was invaluable. This video won't show much about actually setting the theodolite up, as much as it shows about the method for setting out a square line. But I hope to do a bit more of a detailed video about theodolite setup and use on an upcoming project. Also, I have already done the set out. The purpose of this video is to kind of backtrack to give you an idea of how I use that method. So originally, all I had was one line, but you'll see two crossing lines.
So I've set a profile and a string parallel with the house. And where I was expecting to intersect the line with a square line, I've set the theodolite directly above that. So if I show you inside the viewfinder, it's a center line dot. So I had the first string running through with the theodolite directly above it. And once you get it all leveled up, you sight through one end of your string. That's the profile that I've got down there. What you do is you flip the viewfinder. And if I sight through to that profile, you can see crosshairs right on it. It tells me that I'm centered on my line. Now over here, I've got this other profile and I've got my line set up. To get that point 90 degrees from my original line, all I have to do is set it at zero. And as I spin it around, the numbers change. So bring the numbers round close to 90 degrees. And I'll just lock it in. Adjustment. Because we're a different distance, we have to adjust the zoom. And there you can see we're right on that string.
What do you do when the nail's not there? So you have to have a reference for when you're looking through the viewfinder to make a mark so you know where to put your nail. And this is how I go about it. I wouldn't have the nail there in the first place and there'd be no string. And I just sit the survey rod on there and it gives me a bunch of numbers.
When you look through the viewfinder, you can see the numbers. So what I'll do is I'll just spin it away from the nail for a moment. And basically where your measurement is, so there we've got 5, 6, 7. So I would mark
at 5, 6, 7.
And I'd check my mark in the viewfinder. It's bang on, and that's when I put the nail in.
So that gets me one end of the 90 degree line. I basically flip the viewfinder like I did before and I sight down and repeat the same process with the mark, but I've actually set the theodolite up a bit too close so it's blurry, so it's not worth showing you, but you sort of get the gist. So we're good on that end, theodolite's positioned, undo it, flip the viewfinder so it points back this way, we sight through, we put the ruler, all the staff and numbers behind it, we pick the number, mark it, and we've got ourselves a 90 degree line.
So that was a very loose guide on setting out using a theodolite. I hope to show you more, as I said earlier. So thanks for watching. I hope you got something out of it. I feel it was a little bit loose on information, but if you've got any questions, throw them down in the comments. I also know that there are new products on the market, especially using laser technology, which are making theodolites redundant in some aspects of building. For me, it was a cost factor. So now I have the theodolite, I have that option, and hey, in the future, look at getting a laser as well. And on the subject of modern tools, my next episode will be a review on the Dewalt FlexVolt concrete cutoff saw. and it will include a full overview of this project and how I use that saw on the multiple occasions I had to remove concrete. So stay tuned, subscribe, and make sure you catch that episode.